Next, we will discuss the proof of Arden's theorem. Then we will discuss some methods to solve those examples to find out regular expressions from any finite automation using Arden's theorem. And then we have a lot of examples which will be discussed by Choyun. So first, the overview of Arden's theorem. Now, where to apply this Arden's theorem? In order to find out regular expressions of any finite automation, we use this Arden's theorem along with all the properties and identities of regular expression. Now, this is the statement of Arden's theorem. This is very important. So let us read the statement. Let P and Q be the two regular expressions. And if P does not contain any null string, then R is equal to Q plus RP. This equation, it has a unique solution. And this unique solution is R is equal to QP star. So this is actually the statement of Arden's theorem. Now, this Arden's theorem is based on certain assumptions. So there are two assumptions. Firstly, the transition diagram must have no null transitions. And secondly, it must have only one initial state. So let us move to the next slide. So here we discuss the proof of Arden's theorem. So the equation of Arden's theorem is R is equal to Q plus RP, which has a unique solution R is equal to QP star. Firstly, we will prove that R is equal to QP star is a solution of this equation. And for that, we replace the value of R in the equation 1. So we will get R is equal to Q plus QP star into P in the second line. But here, if we take Q as common, we will obtain Q into epsilon plus P star P. Now, P star P or anything R star R is actually R star only, and epsilon plus any R star gives R star only. So here we can substitute this total thing by P star. So we obtain R is equal to QP star. Hence we prove here that R is equal to QP star is a solution of this equation. Next we will discuss that R is equal to QP star is the unique solution of this equation. For that we substitute the value of R here in this parent equation, and we obtain after expanding this that Q plus QP plus RP squared, this type of thing. Now here we get R again. So recursively, if we put R again and again and again, then we will obtain some infinite series kind of thing like Q plus QP plus QP square plus QP cube and so on. And similarly, like the previous one, if we take Q as common, then we will obtain epsilon plus P square plus P cube and so on. But this whole thing is actually nothing but P star only. So we can replace this whole thing by P star, and we will obtain this final equation R is equal to QP star, and hereby we prove that it is the unique solution of this theorem according to Arden's theorem. So next, here is the method. Now we will move on to the practical applications of this Arden's theorem, that is to find out some regular expressions from a finite automata. So if there is any problem given, there are two steps to solve it. Firstly, we will describe each state according to its incoming edges, the values associated with it, and if it is an initial state in the finite automata, then we have to consider the epsilon transition also. Now, for every step, we will write its respective regular expressions based on whatever the incoming edges are coming. This is the first step, and in the second step, we will represent the total solution in terms of the final state. So this is the two steps in the method in which we will solve all the questions related to Arden's theorem to find out regular expressions from finite automata.
So to understand Arden's theorem properly, we have to solve a few problems. So here is the first one. So here an automata is given and we have to find out its regular expression. So here the initial state and final state both is Q1. So first we will form three equations for three states. Now for Q1, there are two incoming edges. One is from Q1 itself with input alphabet A, and another one is from Q3 with input alphabet A. So equation of Q1 will be Q1 is equal to Q1 into A plus Q3 into A plus epsilon, because it is the initial state, so an epsilon will be added here. Now similarly for Q2, there are three incoming edges. One is from Q1 with input alphabet B, another one is from Q2 itself with input alphabet B, and other one is from Q3 with input alphabet B. So equation of Q2 will be Q1 into B plus Q2 into B plus Q3 into B. Similarly, equation of Q3 will be Q3 is equal to Q2 into A. So now we will solve these three equations that we get earlier. Here the earlier PPT is shown in this corner. So the equation in the equation of Q2, first we will substitute the value of Q3. Then in the next step, we will take Q2 as common. Now this is in the form R is equal to Q plus RP. So we will apply Arden's theorem here and we get this result. Q2 is equal to Q1 into B plus AB whole star. Now in the equation of Q1, we will first substitute the value of Q3 with Q2A. And then again, we will substitute the value of Q2 that we get from this previous equation. So now in this equation, we will take common Q1. And again, this is in the form of Arden's theorem, R is equal to Q plus RP. So we will apply Arden's theorem here and we get this final equation. So this is the regular expression that we get from this automata. Now let's see another example. So here another automata is given and we have to find its regular expression. Now in this case, the initial state is Q1 and the final state is Q2. So we have to write three equations for three states. So for Q1, there is only one incoming edge from Q1 itself with input alphabet 0. So equation of Q1 will be Q1 is equal to Q1 into 0 plus epsilon because it is the initial state. Now for Q2, there are two incoming edges. One is from Q1 and another one from Q2 itself. So equation of Q2 is Q1 into 1 plus Q2 into 0. Similarly, the equation of Q3 will be Q3 is equal to Q2 into 1 plus Q3 into 0 plus Q3 into 1. So let's solve the three equations. Now Q1 is equal to Q1 into 0 plus epsilon. This is in the form of Arden's theorem. So we'll apply Arden's theorem here and we get epsilon into 0 star. Now epsilon into 0 star is basically 0 star. So Q1 is equal to 0 star. Now in the equation of Q2, we will first substitute the value of Q1 as 0 star. So again, we can see this is the form of Arden's theorem. We will apply Arden's theorem. So we get Q2 is equal to 0 star into 1 into 0 star. So this is the regular expression that we get from this given automata. Now let's solve another problem. So here a DFA is given and we have to find the regular expression. Now again here the both initial state and final state are Q1. So we will write two equations for two states. Now for Q1, there are two incoming edges. One is from Q2 with input alphabet A. Another one is from Q1 itself with input alphabet B. So equation of Q1 is epsilon plus Q1 into B plus Q2 into A. Epsilon is here for denoting it at initial state. Now for Q2, there are two incoming edges. One is from Q1, another one is from Q2 itself. So equation of Q2 is Q1 into A plus Q2 into B. Now let's solve these two equations. We will apply Arden's theorem in the first step itself because it is in the form. So we get Q2 is equal to Q1 into A into B star. Now in the equation of Q1, first we substitute the value of Q2 as Q1 into A into B star that we get earlier from the equation. Now we will take common Q1 here and this is in the form of Arden's theorem. We will apply Arden's theorem here and we get this final equation. Since the regular expression for this DFA is B plus AB star into A whole star. Now there is another one problem. So we have to find out the regular expression for this DFA. Now here the initial state is Q1 and the final state is Q3. Now we can see that there is no incoming edge in Q1. So equation of Q1 is epsilon because of the initial state. And for Q2, there is only one incoming edge from Q1 with input alphabet A. So Q2 is equal to Q1 into A. And for Q3, similarly, we can write Q1 into B plus Q2 into A plus Q3 into A. So we'll solve the two equations. So first Q2 is equal to Q1A, where we will substitute the value of Q1 as epsilon that we get earlier. So epsilon into A is basically A. Now in the equation of Q3, we will substitute the value of Q1 that was epsilon and the value of Q2 that we get A. So again, this is in the form of Arden's theorem. So we'll apply Arden's theorem here and we get this regular expression finally.
Yeah, very good presentation. Thank you. Excellent presentation. Because Arden's theorem is looks obvious but very difficult to apply. It looks so simple but very good.